Welcome to the Lumbridge Knight Pirates Treasure Quest Guide for Oldschool Runescape. All you need for this quest is to be able to evade a level 4 gardener, 60 coins, and you'll score yourself 2 quest points, a gold ring, an emerald, and 450 coins. Everything else can be found during the course of the quest. So let's find some treasure. Well met, adventurers. I am the Lumbridge Knight, your guide to all things old school RuneScape. Remember to like and subscribe if you don't want to miss out on any of the hints, tips, tricks, and guides that I'll be bringing you on this channel. Blessings of Saradomin be upon you as we venture forth. Here we are at the quest start point in Port Sarim. You can see by the quest log, I can start the quest by speaking to Redbeard Frank in the Rusty Anchor. Here it is on the map. It's not difficult to find, just west of Draenor Village. As you can see, there's Redbeard Frank in the background, and that is the Rusty Anchor pub. To do this quest, as I said in the description, you'll need the items from the summary at the start, but it's also advantageous to bring a Varrock and a Falador teleport, or failing that, if you don't have a high enough magic like me, at least bring the Chronicle that can be bought from Diango in Draenor Village for 300 coins and 150 coins for a teleport card. This will teleport us to the Champions Guild, which will save us a lot of time later on. So here we are talking to Redbeard Frank. He's going to say he knows where some pirates' treasure is. In exchange for that information, he wants some Karamjan rum. Now, unfortunately for us, and hence the nature of this quest, Karamjan rum cannot be imported from the island to the mainland. There's an annoying customs officer who will confiscate it if it's found in your inventory. Equally, if you teleport with it in your inventory, it will disappear. So, we've accepted the quest. Now we need to speak to one of the seamen here. In my case, I'm speaking to Seaman Loris. And pay the 30 coins to board the ferry, the ship, to Karamja. Once we arrive at Karamja, by the way, just as a quick one, for all the transitions where I'm walking or running, I'm going to kind of speed the video up just to kind of make it a bit quicker. We now need to find the bar. So looking at the map, that's the general store. There's the bar. That's where we can buy the rum. So let's head there first. Just going to go straight up to the bar. And for 30 coins, we could buy us a bottle of Karamjan rum from Zambo the bartender. As you can see, we now have the rum in our inventory. And 30 coins for the return journey. So now we need to speak to Luthus. Luthus owns the banana plantation. And this is how we're going to smuggle the rum off the island in one of his banana crates. So in order to do this, we need to ask if he'll give us a job. He'll pay us 30 gold for 10 bananas. Head straight over to the plantation and pick 10 bananas. You pick the bananas simply by clicking on the tree, as I'll demonstrate now. There you go, I've clicked once and one banana's appeared. Keep clicking until the bananas disappear in that particular tree, and then move to another one. As you can see, I've now got 10, so I'm going to head back, and you don't need to speak to Luthus again. Go straight to the crate, use your bottle of rum on the crate, and then rinse and repeat for the 10 bananas. So just click use, make sure you don't click eat or you'll have to go pick another banana. So you have to right click, use, click on the crate. Now again, I'm going to speed the video up because this takes, you know, a couple of minutes and it's pretty boring to watch. So get all 10 bananas in the crate. Once you have all 10 bananas and the rum in the crate, go and speak to Luthas. Basically tell him you've got the 10 bananas, he'll give you your 30 coins for your payment back to Port Sarim. And also ask him where the crates are going. He will tell you that it's going to the general store in Port Sarim. When you've asked those two narrative options, go and speak to the customs officer straight away. Let the customs officer search you. And kind of journey back on the ship. They'll say yes if you search us. Let them search. Obviously, you don't have the room in your inventory, so you're fine. Again, as another note, if you use a teleport with the room in your inventory, it will disappear, so you'll have to come back and buy another bottle and do it again. Cool, so we've arrived in Port Sarim. Now the first thing we need to do is head to the fishing shop and pick up a white apron. It wasn't on the quest requirements at the start in terms of a must-have. Like you can see, I didn't have it in my inventory because you can obtain it on the quest from the fishing shop. just in the corner of the room there, you'll see a white apron hanging up. So we're going to go take that white apron for the next part of the quest. So there you go, I found the white apron. Clicked on it to take, don't worry, none of the NPCs do anything. So there we go. As soon as you've got it, equip it and head across the way, directly south into the general store. You can see it on the map there, it's just south across the way. So head straight there. Hopefully with some run. Obviously you can see from my inventory at the start of this, I didn't have any energy potions, but as with pretty much every quest in RuneScape, having an energy or a stamina potion, if you remember, is definitely advantageous, as would higher agility. So once we get in the general store and you don't run around the table like me, speak to Wyden. Why is it with the names in RuneScape? I just can never pronounce him. Wyden, we're going to call him Wyden. So Wyden, ask him for a job. And because you've already equipped the white apron, he will say, boom, yes, you're very prepared. Here's a job. Go sort the storeroom. So you can't get through this door without the white apron, hence why we needed it. Head there, search the crate with the banana on top. And hey, presto, here is our bottle of rum. Great. Now I take a banana for sentimental value. I've got no idea. Just for the crack. I mean, if you don't have any food with you, maybe take two or three bananas if you're worried about the fight with the gardener later on. There's a level 7 gardener we need to beat. So if you're a low level, maybe, like you can see, I've already got a little bit of food, but you know, as a level 50 character, I'm not in any danger. So quickly return to Redbeard Frank and tell him you have got the rum. Continue through the narrative and he will eventually exchange the rum for a key. Now the eagle-eyed among you may notice Vios there, that's the hooded guy in purple. He is from the X Marks the Spot quest. If you haven't done that, I'll pop a link up on the screen now. Do it, it's another easy quest, and it kind of introduces you to clue scrolls. So if you're not familiar with how to do clue scrolls, it's a great introduction to that particular mechanic of the game. So we've spoke to Frank, we've got the key, and now this is the point where you need to go to the bank or collect a shovel if you haven't already got one. I'm going to use the teleport from the Chronicle, as discussed earlier. If you've got a Varrock teleport, now is the time to use it. Here we are at the Champions Guild, just south of Varrock, because we need to go to the Blue Moon Inn, as that's where Redbeard Frank told us One-Eyed Hector had hidden his treasure. So here we are, we're outside the Blue Moon Inn. You can see there's a blue half-crescent moon, or crescent moon, half-crescent moon, I've just made that up. Anyway, head inside, head straight up the stairs. And if it wasn't blatantly obvious when you reach the top, the big gold and wood treasure chest is the chest we seek. So that head straight through the door, it's not locked, and use the key on the chest. If you click, it'll just say it's locked, you need to use the key to open it. So there we go, we've opened the chest, and we receive a note. On the note it says, visit the city of the White Knights in the park Saradamin points to the X, which marks the spot. Classic pirate clue, X marking the spot, that is. What that refers to, White Knights, obviously it's Falador, and it's the park in Falador. There's a statue of Saradamin which points to a flower arrangement in a rough shape of an X. So, if you have a Falador teleport, now is the time to use it. If your magic isn't high enough, which my character at this point didn't have teleport, I'm going to hoof it there, so I've sped the video up, and here we go. I'm just going to hoof it across, straight to Falador. And once we get through the North Gate, head round to the east and into Falador Park. Those low levels, now you need to be ready for the combat, or you need to run away from the gardener and come back and dig again. So, if I zoom out and move the camera, you can sort of see that that flower bed makes a rough X. That is a statue of Saradamin. And he is pointing towards the center point, the apex of the X. So that is where we're going to dig. Now, as soon as we click use the spade, a gardener's going to appear and say, what the hell are you doing? I'm well high enough to deal with this guy, so I'm just going to kill him. There you go, 3 easy hits and he's dead. If you're low level, run away, wait for him to wander off and then come back. Dig on the spot, and hey presto, there is the casket of One-Eyed Hector's treasure. And 2 quest points. Congratulations. I didn't show it on the video, but the chest contains 1 gold ring, an emerald, and 450 coins. Enjoy. If you have enjoyed this video, and it has been at all helpful, please like, subscribe, share, and leave a comment. I, the Lumbridge Knight, am at your service. So, until the next time, fare thee well, brave adventurers.